Thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. Tonight, on this fine Thursday night, we've got a good one in store between the Jacksonville Jaguars and the Tennessee Titans. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Murray, the lone setback. Mariota now to throw on first down. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
Hey, when Marcus Mariota was at Oregon, throwing to the tight end wasn't much of an option, was it? That spread offense, you didn't have him on the field too much. Now, he's got one of the best in the game in Delanie Walker.
Now, last year, Walker led all the tight ends with 94 catches. Now here's the first carry for DeMarco Murray. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Murray sits third in the NFL in rushing, and he's coming off his third 100-yard game of the season, 107 and a touchdown against the Colts.
Totally rounding back into the form we saw him exhibit in 2014 when he was with Dallas. Loves being the feature guy. Loves staying on the field for all three downs because he can run it, catch it, and he can protect his quarterback.
That was second down run for Murray. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
Well, in 2016 in Tennessee, DeMarco Murray, we're going to find out if it was style, scheme, does he still have it or not. He thinks he's going to be more comfortable with the Titans.
Yeah, because that fall off last year, 2014, over 1,800 yards, 392 carries.
One of the best seasons running the football that we've seen in recent years.
No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down.
I know it's the first half, but it's still hard to curb the enthusiasm for that stop. Third and one, and the offense can't get there. The defensive team has got to feel very good about themselves. Great job out-leveraging the offense.
He'll send this up into the Nashville skyline, and it's a good one. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. Set eye. On the ground, this is T.J. Yeldon. And he cuts left, and he's got an alley. A big third down play there for the Jags. 71 yards. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. Into a mass of bodies, and I think they held him out. They did. No gain on the play, and it's going to be second and goal.
They're right there at the one. No gain, but don't let that stop you. Line back up and keep going at them. If I'm them, I'm thinking about going at it 4 straight times.
To throw on second down. And he's going to go down. This will count as a sack, a very short sack, taken down at the 2.
So they were stopped trying to run the ball on first down. Now they take a sack on second down. The offensive coordinator's got to find a way to flip the script on the defensive coordinator because right now the defense has the advantage.
From back at the 2, here's third and goal. They'll try to punch it in with Yeldon. And he is going to lose yardage here. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's fourth down. Looking at this situation, if you're at the 1, the 2, maybe you go for it. From here, you kick it.
I agree. I think you have to get points in this situation. Fourth down, I don't chance it at all. I put the points on the board and go back and regroup.
And Myers able to knock it through, And the Jaguars grab a 3-0 lead. So not exactly jubilation over on that visiting sideline, but at least a high five or two for their kicker as he gets them the first points of the night here on the opening drive.
And 3 points are not to be underestimated. You're on the road, under the lights, national TV audience. You want to come out and look good, and that's a good start right there.
Myers now converted on the field goal try. Now he's on to kick it away. To return, this is Mark Mariani. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up. But you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving it, giving your defense a chance. Because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number two. They're looking at a 2nd and short yardage to start things out. Again, it's Murray. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. They got 2 of the 3 they needed there. It leaves them with 3rd and just 1 yard.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
A play fake to Murray. Now Mariota. Takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Rashard Matthews, the intended target, and it brings up 4th down.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Here's Brett Kern now as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. This is taken at the 23. Oh, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
A very good return that time. 18 yards. And the Jaguars go on offense. 1st down and 10. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3-point.
The kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash, dude.
Super tough. On offense, the guy that you want to have the best eyes on the field are your quarterback, so you can see everything pre-snap, and then, of course, as the play develops. On defense, oftentimes it's the linebacker, and on this play, his eyes took him right to the ball, and he made a nice tackle.
Now Bortles throwing on 2nd down. He's got time. And the hookup here to Allen Robinson. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. Robinson struggled in week 7. Season lows, just 2 catches and 9 yards for him. Had a couple of drops as well.
It was that kind of game for not just him, but Jacksonville overall. Although a fellow receiver, and it wasn't Allen Hurns, Marquise Lee picked up the slack. What do you have, 7 catches in the game for over 100 yards?
Yeah, his first 100-yard game. Now flags, and we're going to get a delay of game. Following that penalty, the offense really backed up now on 3rd down. They come up in an empty set. 4 wide receivers, 1 tight end. Bortles. He's got time in the pocket, and that is incomplete. He was trying to hit Rashad Green, and now it's fourth down. So on fourth down, here's Brad Nortman on to punt it away. Back deep, Mark Mariani. This is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get sent to take the field. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. A gain of three, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
They go with Murray again. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. Malik Jackson there to make the stop. Big boys down there in the trenches and a nice play to stop them cold. Nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you're talking about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
So third and seven and an extra defensive back on the field here.
Definitely want to play coverage here.
So they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Brett Kern now as he's on to punt for Tennessee. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. It's picked up by the Titans. Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the hunt.
It comes, and he lost the football. Mariota had it jarred loose. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. And now out come the Jags. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play. It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Back to the air on second down. It's Bortles surveying the field. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A lot of time in the pocket there, and the quarterback able to find an open throwing lane, and he delivered.
What a terrific job by the guys up front, able to tamp down the pass rush that they've been getting all day.
And now a first down following that long gain. Throwing on first down is Bortles. Over the middle, it's Thomas. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here we go with second and seven.
Hey, we've got tight left. Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Keep it. Keep it tight end. Ready. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Again, they'll throw with Bortles. This will be caught at the two. And he's able to get it down to the two-yard line. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. T.J. Yeldon taking it in from a yard out. And the Jaguars add six to their lead. And that'll give them a two-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here in the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Hey, we
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
When you're putting together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're playing in the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Now a give. This is Murray. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. They'll come out in the pistol. Second half begins with a run by Yeldon. Oh, what a juke into space. It goes as a pickup of 23. And the Jags are going to have a first down.
Okay, let's do our version of name dropping here. Let's show off a little knowledge, right? The A-gap, the gap between the center and the guard on either side, right? Both sides. Control that, you're going to control an inside running game.
And he had to feel satisfied because he hit that gap, broke the contact. He loves that.
That's the best part, right? That's what he's going to ask the coach to run back on film.
Let me see that one more time.
Show that again, coach. Look how my legs kept turning. I just kept moving, and he did to the tune of a big game.
Denora Searcy in on the stop.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Play clock hit zero. Don't know what went wrong there, Charles, but it's going to cost some 5 yards.
Has to be some organization from the sideline. Sometimes when you're trying to decide on what play to send in, the play caller has to move a little bit faster.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a second and 13 now. After the penalty, it's Yeldon. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Just a yard there, so it brings up a tough third and 12.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Play action. Now it's Bortles. He's got time. He sets to fire deep. And he will get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. Allen Robinson, 53 yards. And the Jaguars add on to their lead. Well, they went play action there and set it up nicely for him. I mean, he can flat fly, and they hit him downfield.
And it doesn't take much to create that extra bit of space that a guy of his speed needs. If you go play action, all you want is just a moment where the guy's covering, take their attention somewhere else, and then he's by him. And once he's by him, there's no catching him. As they always like to say, if a receiver's even to a defensive back, that means he's leaving.
Unless that DB is Charles Davis, right?
In that case, he left me a long time ago.
Come on now.
Trust me.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Antonio Andrews now to return. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. Out come the Titans now. They'll have it first on offense to start the third. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10, kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use, just something to get you off to a quick start.
It's Roy Miller that brought him down.
One thing I do know about DeMarco Murray, he loves to pile up carries. You know, a lot of backs are concerned about how many they have. Not him. He wants the ball all the time. But so far in this game, that's not working too well, and his team's losing.
He's had a decent chunk of carries. He just hasn't had much success when he's gotten those carries. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Pretty good running there. 9 yards. Sets up a third and one. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
They'll run here. It's Murray. And he's brought down, but following a pretty juke move that gives him the first down. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
Everyone understood their role on that play. Third and one. You know, the defensive guys, they're trying to get down and get low and get leverage on the offensive lineman, but they didn't allow that to happen. They created a crease and allowed him to get through for a first down.
First down, Mariota. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. A wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now second down. You know, Charles, a quick glance back at week 7, an inordinate number of turnovers. On Sunday alone, 39 in 13 games, that's 3 a game. So a lot of teams looking to clean up play a little bit.
Well, we always hear coaches talk about ball security. I mean, you can't go to a production meeting or a press conference and not hear that. But at the same time, what you don't hear as loudly, but preached as fervently, taking the ball away, raking it out of their hands, knocking it out. That's what the defensive guys are doing. So both sides continuing to try and get better.
Deshaun Gibson there on the tackle.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Here's Mariota. He gets it left side to Johnson. 4 yards on the pickup, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses, It's understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They'll start out on the ground. It's T.J. Yeldon, and he'll get this up over the 25 to the 26. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down. Back now in Nashville. It's Jaguar football here, and they'll look to extend their lead as we begin quarter number four. Yeldon, the lone running back. They'll give it to him here. And this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Derek Morgan in on the stop. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop him here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Completes it left side to the tight end Lewis. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. They come out here in the eye. They go play action here on first down. Caught right side. It's Lewis. Oh, he's got a little daylight. It's picked. There he goes left side. And they're going to bring this one back. A fumble return touchdown for the Titans. This defense, Charles, they needed some type of a spark to help get them back in this game. I think they just got their spark.
No doubt about it. You know, that's all they discussed. How can we get ourselves moving again? How can we get our team going? This definitely qualifies.
Ryan Succapon for the point after. And it's 17-7. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. On the return, this is Denard Robinson. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. First down, and his throw here is incomplete. Marquise Lee, the intended target, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. Again, we'll see the pistol here. On second down, here's Yeldon. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out. A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
They can pass. Throwing his Bortles on third down. He's got the hook up to Lee. And he's brought down after a good game. They convert on third with a gain of 22.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
Oh, so frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay. First and 15 here behind the chains. They come out here in the eye. Bortles going to give the Yeldon. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Well, there they went blitz defensively, Charles, and things were paved well coming from the linebacker position.
I love the way that you described it, paved well. Oftentimes, the guy who gets home on the blitz, he's going to get all the credit, but his teammates did all the dirty work, right? They ran into people on purpose. They sometimes tugged on jerseys to hold linemen to create space and gaps. And that play finished off really, really well. Well conceived, well designed, and even better executed.
Yards to go. It's third down. Another pistol look here. Now a first carry here for Robinson. And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. A first down carry now for Yeldon. And he got now another timeout here called by the Titans. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. It's already second and 12. The defense hoping to push him back more. Yeldon, the lone running back. He'll get the football here. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long.
There we go now. Green, nine.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll get nothing out of that one. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
That's my house. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. And this will be spotted on the other side of the field. It's a 61-yard attempt. He had the distance, but it's no good. Wide to the right, and this score will stay right where it is. So with that miss, Charles, you have to figure their fate, it might be sealed.
Yeah, you needed two scores. So you take the field goal first and then worry about getting the ball back, but that may not matter now.
He's got time in the pocket. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Sheds a second man.
He's building up some momentum, isn't he?
And he's brought down after a good game. And a nice gain of 21 yards. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Yards still left on second down. Now Mariota. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was looking for DeMarco Murray out of the backfield, and it's third down. So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. Henry, the lone man in the backfield. Mariota to throw. Deep drop. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off by Prince Amukamara. And the return will stop him well inside their own 20 at the 15-yard line. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set to go again. The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can't do anything. So kneel it down, take it home.
No doubt about it. It's what you practice for in winning situations each and every week. Victory formation. Take a knee and go on into the locker room and celebrate.
Call it a victory.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.